have such high level race control and whatever it may be. But the other huge thing about the pro Indy, the absolute extreme level of safety that we have being associated with IndyCar, being able to have access to the AMRC. We cannot oversell that fact. And talking about anywhere from 14 to 22 years of age racing here in USF 2000 program.
Familiar face, right?
Yes.
AMR safety crew members know these drivers and the more you get rattled on these cars, there's nothing better to know than you have the very best coming to your attention, and you usually have a familiar face when you reach you in the car. So, a lot to be said, and our thanks to the AMR safety team for their not only quick reactions to any incidents that we have on the racing circuits, but to ensure that these track preparations and the track safety is at the utmost forefront and 100% each and every time we go racing.
One interesting thing, Michael, obviously the next particular track session is practice for the NTT IndyCar Series, but it's not like we can borrow from one of our own road needs sessions and just push it up a little bit. You're hoping potentially to get another minute to get it added to the slot. But it's tough to do that knowing that the IndyCar guys are going to be set to come out here. I believe their session starts at 3:15 at 17 minutes from now, even if we got a couple more laps, a couple more minutes. I'm sure that there's some heating going on in race control right now to try to slip away a couple of minutes potentially between the two sessions.
You see the tire barriers getting cinched up off the signaling. For the safety crew members to come over to check the tire barriers out. Rob said, you see on the video screen, 3 minutes remaining in this qualification session. The tough thing is, even if they get it really prepared in the next 2 minutes and they don't extend the session, they won't even have an opportunity to really get a good lap in any of the games now.
And you mentioned in the beginning of